The following is a special presentation of the National Lacrosse League.
Week 9 of the National Lacrosse League wraps up in Uncasville, Connecticut. Inside Mohegan Sun Arena, the Georgia Swarm take on the New England Black Wolves. Crucial implications for the East Division in the NLL. Black Wolves up a half game in front of Philadelphia, who got a win on Friday night. Riptide fell last night for the second time this weekend. Georgia and New England, their first games of the weekend. You're watching the NLL on BR Live. Brendan Glasheen and Jack Piatelli, a former Boston Blazer. Black Wolves in the midst of their best start in franchise history at 4-0. Story overall from start of the season to now has been the defense.
They've been the most consistent part of this team. The reason why they're 4-0, they've done a very good job holding teams down. Some of their best players they've played against on the offensive end slowed them down and eliminated a lot of quality shots in the first four games.
New England 8.5 goals against, that second best in the NLL. Thrilled to have Greg Downing back in the mix. This is his third game back from injury. Hurt himself in the World Championships, the indoor championships in Vancouver. So to have Downing back in the mix, 12 years in the league, you see, 34 years old, a veteran that really leads by example.
Yeah, great leadership on the floor. He's very active on the defensive end. He runs the floor extremely well, vacuum on ground balls, and he can run the transition game. He's one of the leaders on the transition game. Look for him today to get the ball up the floor.
11 loose balls in two games for Downing, and he's been a great example for a young player like Joe Nardella. A great story, tried out for the team last year, makes the team this year. He didn't make it last year. Jack, he's not just your classic face-off guy, brings a lot more to the table.
Well, he made the team as a defender, not as a face-off guy, and he's really studied the game and picked up the defensive plans for the New England Black Wolves. He's great on loose balls. He actually has have a number of turnovers this year, and he's got a great motor.
Third on the team in loose balls with 23. For more on the Black Wolves defense, the third member of our team, Robin Brown, joins the defensive coordinator of New England, Clem D'Orazio.
Thanks, Brendan. Coach, when it comes to scouting a team like Georgia, so many different offensive weapons, where will you look to limit some of their shots?
I think the big thing is owning the middle of the floor tonight. They obviously got a lot of weapons out there, like you mentioned. So if we can handle the middle of the floor and limit them to the areas that we want them to shoot from, take away back door, we should be okay.
Let's transition to Dougie Jamison in between the pipes. So impressive so far, but what's impressed you most about him thus far?
Probably his consistency and how much he's matured over the last 3 years with us as an organization. He's just been a really good guy for the team, and he's been doing a great job in there.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
Brendan?
Robin, thanks very much. And look, this is the number one team in the power play in the Georgia Swarm that New England is going against. So defense, not only when it's 5-on-5, but also the power play is very important. Shane Jackson has been a star for this team, leading the team in points with 30, but also he's got 3 goals in at least every game through 5 this year.
He's become an elite player in this league and one of my favorite players to watch. Very active on the floor, not big in stature, plays tough. You know, creates a lot of space for his teammates. One of the better shooters in the game. He can feed, he can shoot, he can really do it all.
3-3 last week at New York, and Randy Stotts, while he hasn't been scoring the ball all that much, he had 9 assists last game against New York. He's really finding his teammates, but also does a lot of the dirty work as well, picking up loose balls.
Got a number of loose balls, 26 assists for the season, and if he gets his shooting down, gets better quality shots today, he's a guy that New England really has to watch out for. Even though he has only 4 goals, he's very dangerous when he has the ball.
Stotts, number one in the NLL in assists, as Jack mentioned, with 26. We'll have the opening faceoff at Mohegan Sun Arena when we return. Georgia and New England in the East Division. The NLL on BR Live is brought to you by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Visit geico.com to see how much you could save. And And we're back here inside Mohegan Sun Arena getting set for Georgia and New England. These two teams facing off for the first time this year. First time, of course, since division realignment. Both teams in the East Division, just like previous years, but with Philadelphia and New York as the other competitors. Georgia has not lost three games in a row since 2016. So this is uncharted territory, as we say every week and every week in the NLL as we close week nine. The start to the game is going to be very crucial, especially for Georgia here. Early start, got in last night. You didn't have a game to play last night, so there's no momentum coming in as the national anthem wraps up. So can you attest to that as far as the start of the game?
Yeah, very important. Fortunately for Georgia, they practiced for 2 hours last night. They were able to get the floor last night and practice so to get accustomed to this smaller surface. And again, that may help their start getting out here. And they had a very good practice.
Let's look at the keys to the game today between the Swarm and Black Wolves. Jack for Georgia. Weird enough, Coach Eddie Cuomo said, let's be less unselfish.
Yeah, last couple of contests, they had some quality shots that his offensive players weren't taking. So, you know, they want them to take more shots. If they have a shot, expect them to shoot more often tonight.
And we have the top two penalty killing and power play teams in the league today. Georgia first on the power play, second on the PK. New England second on the power play and first on the penalty kill. So penalties today, depending on how many they are, whoever controls that battle will be crucial too.
Yeah, both teams take a lot of pride in their special teams. New England has done an outstanding job with their man down team. And Georgia obviously number one in the league on the power play. Last week, New England did not have a power play, so they'd like to get one today, and that could come down to the power plays.
As we discussed from the start of the game, New England defensively has been excellent. Our own Robin Brown is now joined by the faceoff man and the defenseman, Joe Nardella.
Joe, after your epic battle with Trevor Baptiste last weekend, what type of impact are you looking to make from the faceoff?
Hoping to give our team a lot of chances on the offensive end. If we can give those guys possession, as you see what's happened early on in the season in some of our games, guys like Crawford, Riley O'Connor, Andrew Pugh, Davey Emela, those guys get hot once they get more touches, so just trying to feed them the ball and do my part.
Thanks, Joe. Good luck.
No problem.
Brendan?
Robin, Joe, thank you very much. Mike Poulin is in the goal for Georgia. One-time goaltender of the year in the NLL back in 2012, his 14th season. There's the head coach of the Black Wolves in his fifth season, Glenn Clark. Just the second head coach in franchise history. Glenn, 40-36 in his five seasons. Doug Jamison coming off his second 50-plus save game of his career. Jamison, a fourth-year player, just 24 years old. He made 50 stops against Philadelphia in that overtime win for New England last Saturday night. It's Nardella against the captain of Georgia, Jordan McIntosh, and the Black Wolves win the first one. Slithering through, that is Malcolm. Lost it momentarily. Georgia fights for the loose ball. Swarm, as you can imagine, in the gold and blue road uniforms. 3-on-2 break out the back door. That was Krepinsek, the defenseman. Multiple whistles blow.
Looks like Georgia's gonna go for a penalty. Too many men on the floor. We talked about power plays. We didn't have any last week. New England.
Takes 25 seconds to get their first today.
Georgia penalty, bench minor.
Could be a very good way to start this contest against Georgia.
Ed Cuomo and his staff. Cuomo, champions of the NLL in 2017. He's made the postseason in all 4 years as the head coach. So New England is on the power play, the leader for the Black Wolves when it comes to power play goals. Callum Crawford has four. Here he is off the screen. Skip pass fired there by Resetera to top the mark. Extra chance, still five to shoot. A fake by Crawford, save Poulin. Here comes Georgia the other way. It's Joel White, 2-on-2 despite the man down. White gets sandwiched by a couple of Black Wolves. For more than a minute gone by, there's a hit. New England forces that ball back out. Still a minute 15 to go on the power play.
Nice to see New England be aggressive on ball. They're gonna have to be very aggressive in order to slow this offense down for Georgia.
Black Wolves give it right back. Jameson covers it up. Nice adjustment by Dougie.
Those are the kind of shots you want to give up. Right in front of Dougie, he can see the ball coming. Great position.
Still 45 seconds in this extra chance. New England second in the NLL on the power play, 9-for-15. Here's a look now from the defensive perspective. Another crucifying hit in front. Joel White goes down. He collides with Riley O'Connor.
Georgia 44, minor penalty, check from behind.
It's against Chad Tutton.
Chad Tutton going out for a cross check. New England will have a two-man advantage. They spent a lot of time yesterday at practice working on their power play. New England has not done a very good job controlling the ball on offense. Too many turnovers early on in this game. They need to be smarter with the ball and be a little more patient.
Now remember, Georgia is the second best penalty kill team in the league. Top two teams in both categories on special teams. Lyle Thompson is with it. Plenty of pressure on him. Three on the shot clock. Thompson just fires. He's made a few of those, so don't be surprised if a 30-footer can skitter in. He's got Steph Curry range in comparison to basketball.
And he had two guys. Thompson had two players, defenders on him, and still was able to get a shot off. Great stick protection. Tough to take the ball away from Thompson. Obviously, great college career and tremendous professional career.
Now it's 5-for-4. Crawford, that ball slid right behind the right leg, stick side of Poulin. His defense bails him out. Lyle Thompson is on milestone watch today. He is 6 points from 400 in his career. It's just his fifth season as a pro. Here's the righty, Randy Stotts. Looking to barrel through the defense. New England puts some pressure on top. Three defenders come in, four to shoot. And there's nothing doing there for Miles Thompson.
See how big and strong Stotts is. Great stick control, but he uses his body so well, better than most. The Black Wolves really have to keep an eye on him because he creates a lot of space on that offensive end for Georgia.
Bit of a feeling out process early on, and there's a score. Andrew Q was held scoreless last week, and the rookie, third overall pick, has his seventh goal in his rookie season.
Number of chances on the power play for New England. If you watch the defense for the Swarm, they packed it in tight, which left Q open up top. He had plenty of time and space to get that shot up. That's actually where he shoots the ball best, up high, set. Great accuracy, velocity. Nice to see him get one early on.
Third power play goal of the season for Andrew Q. He's now up to 7 goals, 20 points in his rookie campaign. Black Wolves selected Q with their highest pick, the third overall pick, since 2011. That's dating back to the Philadelphia years. So it was a big deal that New England drafted as high as it did to bring in a talent like Andrew Q.
Very pleased with his play this year. So much talent. He's long, he's lengthy, he's got a great shot and sees the field extremely well.
Zach Miller, who had 2 goals last week, the rookie, undrafted free agent out of Denver, coughs it up on the swing pass.
Over and back, possession goes to New England.
You know something, that goal for the Black Wolves, it's gotta feel real good for the coaching staff. We talked to Coach Gibson and Coach Clark yesterday. They've set up a lot of two-man sets in practice, designed sets to get the lefty forwards involved after a lack of involvement last week in just an 8-goal effort against Philadelphia.
Even if they have to get them going on the power play, it's good to see they're getting some shots and opportunities on that left side.
Tutton in transition. Black Wolves scoop up the loose ball behind the cage.
Looks like New England may go out for too many men on the floor. So Georgia's going to have an opportunity to tie this game up.
Illegal substitution.
Legal substitution. Two men on the floor. Number one power play in the league.
This is Ty Logan, the rookie, who last played in the QSLL for the Capital Axemen, undrafted pickup for the Black Wolves back in the fall. On the doorstep, there's a stop. Again, have to reiterate, top two teams in the league on the power play and on the penalty kill. Here's the righty, Stotts. Lane gets shut down, kicks out. This is Jordan Hall, who is picked up again in free agency, a score on the door. Shane Jackson. He might only be 5'9", but he is mighty on the door. Georgia ties it up.
Black Wolves coaching staff very concerned with the way they move the ball east to west. That backdoor look to Jackson, tough to defend. Anytime Jackson gets the ball low inside, he puts it away.
Shane Jackson has a hat trick in each of the team's five games coming in. Had a nice conversation with Ed Cuomo this morning before the game. He's so high on this young man, Jackson, from Bowmanville, Ontario, played for Team Canada. He was a unanimous vote by all the assistant coaches to make that team. And again, you look at him, and Coach Cuomo said you might find him at the supermarket or he might be a school teacher. Totally just messing around about Shane, but he loves his compete.
And he didn't stop playing lacrosse till he was 13 years of age.
That's something.
And be able to get to this level, not only play at this level, but be one of the elite players. He's only 5'9", 180 pounds. He's tough. He's very active, extremely skilled. Works very hard at his game.
And to your point, starting at just the teenage years, a great story for young players. Nice save by Dougie Jamison, locked in after that score. Tied at one, you're watching. Next weekend, the NLL Game of the Week moves to Las Vegas as Connor Fields and the Seals host Dylan Ward, hashtag trade Ward, and the Mammoth at Orleans Arena. Catch all the action on BR Live, Twitter, and Facebook starting at 9:30 p.m. Eastern with a special half-hour edition of NLL Game Day Live. We're back here at Mohegan Sun. Week 9 is wrapping up. Black Wolves and Swarm for a big East Division clash here, tied at one early on. Black Wolves on offense. Here's Callum Crawford, one of the top scorers in the league yet again. Some space. Poulin deflects it with the bottom of his pad. Another save for the 35-year-old Mike Poulin.
Resetiris and Crawford played some really good two-man game down below. It opened up a lot of space for Crawford. But Poulin comes up with a nice save.
Nice pick set by Lyle Thompson up top. There's his shot, whistles wide. It's a nice idea. Shot clock runs out, New England possession.
All even, both teams offensively played a little sloppy in terms of quality of passes and shots early on in this game.
Black Wolves 1-for-2 on the power play early on. Another save for Poulin, the rebound, another stop. That was LeBlanc, or rather it was O'Connor that went down. Black Wolves can reset the offense. Under 8 minutes to go in the quarter.
That was a great loose ball rebound by Durson to get that shot off. And Poulin, quick to make the save.
Mike Poulin locked in after allowing an early goal. Poulin up to 6 saves. Early going, midway through this first quarter. Here's Jackson, skips it up top, bouncer, it's deflected. Zed Williams gave it a rip. That ball was deflected, no over and back. Shot clock is down to 8. Clock resumes now, 5 seconds. Jackson skips a pass in, looking for Hall, scooped up by Jamison.
New England's defense, that was John LaFontaine, doing a nice job getting their sticks in the passing lanes, even the shooting lanes.
Fontaine acquired a couple of years ago from Saskatchewan in a trade that sent Evan Kirk back to the Rush.
And we're going to get some quality shots. Poulin doing a nice job stepping out and making the saves.
McIntosh fumbled it in transition, had one-on-one. Georgia settles down, 12 to shoot. Skip feed here by Miller. In front, Jameson, a wall once again, a long outlet. And the Black Wolves aren't ready. That was Chaikowski, who did not have his head up. I think Brett Manny was shouting to him. As we learned, sometimes in this building, when the music is rocking, it's hard to hear and have awareness on the floor.
But when Chaikowski is running up the floor like that, he's got to anticipate Jameson looking to make the pass to him.
Off the pick, it's Stotts. Tries to regroup, setting a pick for Miles Thompson.
Moving pick on the swarm possession, New England.
Still a feeling out process here at Mohegan Sun, especially for Georgia. We discussed the start to the game and the level of urgency. We asked head coach Ed Como about how Georgia would come out, and he said it's more so consistency as opposed to urgency, but you want a blend of those two elements, especially when you've lost three games in a row. On the shovel, New England sticks with it. Pressa Terrence over to Crawford. Nice pick by Emela. Crawford has breathing room to Emela. Jump shot, rebound, O'Connor is there. Goal is waved off. O'Connor was in the crease, so was Emela. Moreover, Poulin goes down. There was some shoving after that interaction on the doorstep.
That was a great offensive set series for New England. Unfortunately, Emela was unable to get that shot off, was in the crease. When Riley got the ball and put it away, obviously no goal. Emela sprawled across the crease. But I like the offensive set. A lot of movement off ball, a lot of ball movement.
So no goal, seven saves in the game for Mike Poulin, four for Doug Jameson. Hall flips it underneath the goal line. Jackson secures it. Now it's Hall again up top. Zach Miller hesitates. He blasts that one over the crossbar. Well, both teams are not shy, and I think we're seeing Georgia taking that approach that the head coach wanted, being a little less unselfish and more aggressive.
Yeah, Georgia's very good inside. You can't give up the inside to Georgia because they've got so many quality shooters.
The lefties squirm out. Crawford fires on the run. Tough start to the day for Callum Crawford after the game winner last week in overtime against Philadelphia. Black Wolves in the midst of their best start in franchise history, 4-0.
I will say though, Callum is getting some good quality shots. Poulin is just doing a nice job. Testing him, making
and
the save.
A score on the right side here for Georgia. Hall in the right spot. And the Swarm take a 2-1 lead. This is a great pick here, Jack, to set up Lyle Thompson.
Pick, screen, whatever you want to call it, but a good hesitation on that shot. Got Jameson to move, and he wasn't able to recover, found the opening of the net to take a 2-1 lead.
So Lyle Thompson with that score is up to 14 goals on the season. Lyle entered the weekend, or rather entered today, tied for seventh in the NLL in goals. One behind his teammate Shane Jackson. Thompson had four goals in Georgia's last game at New York, a heartbreaker that was lost in overtime. Delivery by O'Connor, whistles wide. Georgia wants to run. Here comes Adam Wiedemann. The lefty defenseman stomps on the brakes. Offense spills in here for Georgia. Zach Miller flings it to Stotts. Zed Williams sets the screen. Stotts on the run, tries to sting the corner. and he comes up empty. Black Wolves have it.
Swarm like to start their offense up high and trying to find something low. New England did a nice job to keep the lower part of the offensive floor jammed up.
That was one of the keys for Coach D'Orazio yesterday, Black Wolves defensive coach, who is taking over assistant GM duties after today. Rich Lisk on hand for his final game as GM. There's a jump shot look with three to shoot for Crawford. Callum has created some breathing room. Some quality looks. Georgia has taken the lead here at Mohegan Sun. Lyle Thompson with the hesitation as Jack referenced to put the Swarm in front 2-1. Under three to play in this first quarter, 2-1 Georgia. Third member of our crew is Robin Brown. She is joined by the Black Wolves head coach, Glenn Clark.
Coach Clark, down by just one goal, but three forced turnovers from the shot clock. What are you noticing about the defense, the pressure that your defense is applying?
They're doing a good job. You know, we know what this team is. They're very dynamic offensively. And we've done a good job so far about being active, staying on their hands, and not really giving them hands-free shots. So I think we've done a good job so far, but we knew this game was going to be a battle of attrition. We got two great teams, and it's a long way from over.
Thank you, Coach.
You're welcome, Robin.
Brendan?
Long way from over, Jack, in order to improve to 5-0 and keep this historic run going. Any takeaways from what Coach had to say?
Yeah, it's going to get down to possessions, obviously, face-offs. Both goaltenders have played extremely well early. I'd give the advantage to Georgia in terms of their flow on offense, moving the ball very well from side to side, more active in terms of creating space. But again, New England's gotten some good quality shots. Poulin has just been able to come up with the saves.
Watch all of the action from around the NLL this season on PR Live. Choose an annual, monthly, or per-game pass. For more information, visit nll.com/brlive. On the rebound, Black Wolves have had a few of those chances. We certainly appreciate you, those of you stopping by to watch the end of Week 9 in the National Lacrosse League. Is it Malcolm? That's Riley O'Connor. His stick was stuck in the net.
He almost came up with that loose ball and put the shot away.
Kick out to Jackson off the shoulder pad of Jameson. He rises properly. Shot clock resets to 30. Miles Thompson goes down. Now whistles blow. Should make mention our crew today. The crew chief is Ryan Fowler, assistant referees Matt Garrison and Kyle Kropman.
Good defensive series right here for New England. Got to put a lot of pressure on the ball in order to be successful against this Swarm team. We might have an issue with the shot clock and the game clock. That's why the game has stopped. Officials talking it over. Talking to Glenn Clark, you have to get your stick on the Swarm's hands when they go to shoot.
So play resumes, shot clock at 24. Hall was looking backdoor to one of his teammates. Got lost in the shuffle. Here come the Black Wolves. It's Tony Malcolm, who had a transition goal last week. He's got one in Week 9. We're tied at 2 at Mohegan Sun.
I was just going to talk about the transition game. We haven't seen a lot early on in this game. Malcolm is as fast as anybody in this game. He gets up the floor so quickly, handles the ball. Last week, very similar situation in terms of where he was from the goal. Was an offensive player early on in his career, but he can run the floor. He's got a good shot from outside, back-to-back goals. Certainly going to help this team if they can get the transition game going.
When the Black Wolves acquired Tony Malcolm, he was acquired by a trade last October. they did not want him really for his offensive game, and he was great offensively for the Vancouver Warriors. 13 goals, 25 assists, which were a career best, 38 points. He's come in this season, goal last week, double-digit loose balls in against the Philadelphia Wings, so he's been a great addition in the transition game. Here's Tchaikovsky. He wants a turn.
Moving pick on Brett Manny.
So that faltered the opportunity for the Black Wolves as we're under a minute to go in the first, tied up at two.
It's the little things like that, setting picks and getting called for a moving pick, loose balls, that are gonna make big difference in this game.
Stotts with the diagonal feed to Jackson. He's denied. One thing Coach Clem D'Orazio, told us, the defensive coach for New England, really spotting and covering up those lefty creases. And since Jackson scored early on, he hasn't had much room to work with.
And not a lot of possessions either.
Turnover New England. Shot clock has been turned off. So Georgia can hold for the final shot. Poulin is out of the goal, so six forwards on the floor. 7 seconds. Hall into Jackson, back to Hall. Now it's Lyle Thompson to Stotts. Final seconds, drift down, and no more shots for Georgia. We've reached the end of one. Here at Mohegan Sun, back and forth we go. East Division clash, Georgia and New England. Shane Jackson on the board in this one, and Lyle Thompson also delivering. Must-win situation for Georgia. Fired up, Glenn Clark, head coach of the New England Black Wolves. Jack Piattelli alongside. I'm Brendan Glasheen. Jack, what do you think the message is right there from Coach Clark after what's been a slower start to the game, I'm sure, better than he hoped for?
Continue to battle, play smarter. Let's try and get this transition game going. And let's move the ball more on offense. Three more periods to go. It's a long game.
McIntosh against Nardella. Right now it's advantage McIntosh. He's won four of a total of 11. Check that, six faceoffs to Nardella's two. But New England on the wing scoops the ball up. Here's Andrew Q. Scored the first goal of the game for the Black Wolves. Did not score last week against Philadelphia. Black Wolves 4-0 atop the East Division. Little flip from Crawford. Rested Terrence, couldn't bury it. Must-win scenario for Georgia, having lost three in a row for the first time in 4 years. Swarm right now at 2-3, third place in the East. New York lost last night. Riptide 1-7. Bounce shot misses wide from Stotts. He is yet to score in this one, had no goals last week. Now it's Stotts again off the pick. Missiles that ball wide. Good look, though, for Stotts.
Yeah, and for a big guy, he's really moves well on the floor. Two shots in a row for him. Again, just because he's big and lanky doesn't mean he can't move and handles the ball so well. And his lacrosse IQ was off the charts. Understands the game so well.
Outshot O'Connor, Randy Stott, 6'2", 200 bills. Crawford sticks with it, shot clock reset. He recycles the ball, this is O'Connor. As a one-on-one matchup, O'Connor works to the middle of the floor. Save Poulin. I think Mike Poulin might be one of the most motivated guys from that New York loss last week. I mean, look, it's still early. New York is going to improve as the year goes on, but I'm sure there's a chip on your shoulder when you've been in this league for more than a decade and you allow 13 to an expansion team.
Another illegal substitution against the Swarm. Second one of the game for the Swarm. Swarm is trying to slow down the transition game and get on the floor quickly, efficiently. My correction, maybe a slash.
Mm-hmm. New England on the power play for the third time, 1-for-2 today. We discussed the battle on the penalties. Right now, each team has a power play score. On the door, it's Resiteritz. Ball gets dragged out. Resiteritz is bodied in outlet Georgia. As McIntosh take a gamble, he decides to kick out. It's Tutton, whirls one. That ball off the pipe. Chad Tutton gave that a rip after twirling the ball a few times. Cradled in his stick, almost a shorty for Georgia. Make no mistake, this Swarm team can still beat you with that three-headed monster offensively, despite being a man down. Two shorthanded goals this season through five games. Stotts, sneak attack, and a save, Jameson.
Stotts was able to get so much space. Good, quick shot. They are dangerous when they're man down.
Less than a minute to go on the power play. Resiteritz, Crawford, Q up top in this set. Crawford off a few picks on the door, he scores! First of the afternoon for Callum Crawford, and that pick play, two picks, as a matter of fact, open the door for number 98.
You may not be able to stop Callum, slow him down, but you're not gonna stop him. Great face dodge. Does a nice job getting to the goal line, getting his stick across the crease. Gives him a lot of space to get that ball on the far side of the goal. Nice to see him get one.
So New England has a 3-2 lead. 3 minutes into this second quarter, Callum Crawford with the goal is up to 15 on the season, pacing the Black Wolves. Crawford entered play today, third in the NLL in goals, a top five scorer. Missiles this one wide. Georgia wants to push. New England has scored consecutive goals after going down 2-1. Moreover, the Black Wolves are 2-for-3 on the power play today. England is now 11-for-18 on the season on the power play. Better than 60%. Here's Randy Stotts curling around the D. Jackson flips it to Miles Thompson. 10 on the shot clock here. Zach Miller cutting in. Miller gets the beat. Bouncer goes. Terrific look by Jackson to find the rookie Zach Miller. Tied up at 3.
Beautiful backdoor cut by Zach Miller. No defenders to be found. Look at all the time, the space. Five hole beats. Jameson, take another look. Nice handle. New England defense watching the ball instead of the backside behind the defense. You can't afford to give up that space in front of the goal, especially against the Swarm. They're so dangerous down low.
Zach Miller has fitted nicely on the left side after Holden Cotone was lost in expansion. So they had a void to fill on that left side. They get Zach Miller, who was an undrafted free agent pickup last year for San Diego, product of the University of Denver. Nice save. Poulin uses that glove side after a diving play by Resiteritz. So we're even at 3 here at Mohegan Sun, wrapping up week 9 in the NLL. Black Wolves are 4-0, one of two undefeated teams remaining after Halifax got a big win last night to improve to 6-0. Georgia has lost 3 games in a row, uncharted territory for the Swarm. Jameson read that ball well. Outlet to Stotts, and foot was in the crease, so possession to New England.
The official was right there to make the call. Little turnovers like that, you know, to come down to the end of the game in terms of possessions.
battle of the trenches. We talk so much about the power play, but also that work in the dirty areas. Crawford tries a jump shot. O'Connor setting the screen. Swing looking for Q. On the loose ball, it's Cody Zellers. Zellers was on it. And we get multiple whistles. So New England and Georgia are tied up. Black Wolves took a two-goal lead. Georgia comes back. Callum Crawford, his first of the night, beating Mike Boulin. And the other way, Zach Miller, the second year with a... We're tied up at three here at Mohegan Sun. It's mascot day to celebrate Hunter the Wolf. And his birthday, he's on the floor. So he's got all his buddies here. Let's see which buddy is joining Robin Brown, the third member of our team. It's one of the coaching staff, a member of the coaching staff.
Coach, all of Georgia's goals coming right inside the perimeter, none from deep. How do you think your team is doing getting towards the crease?
It's funny, we talked about just the dynamics of this arena. It's so small, we talked about starting wider. Getting to the middle of the floor with speed, it's really hard to defend. So that's what we're trying to do, and so far the guys are doing a good job.
Thank you, Coach.
Thanks.
Brendan?
Thank you, Robin. That's Dan Lattiser, the offensive coach for Georgia. He actually, fun story about Coach Lattiser. Last year, Jack, when we were here, Derek Keenan, who was the head coach of the Saskatchewan Rush, he does an annual fishing trip with Coach Clark, and Coach Lattiser also partakes. They go on a fishing trip every offseason, and right before we wrapped up our conversation with Ed Cuomo, I said, hey, Eddie, you got to get invited this year? And he actually has been invited once, but he respectively declined. He's not much of a fisher, so Coach Lattiser, Coach Clark, they oftentimes reel him in. I'm not sure how great of a fisher you are, but I never catch anything.
I'm not a good fisher at all.
They never actually told us how good they were at it. They just enjoyed the trip.
Yeah, as you know, these coaches have a lot of respect for each other, admiration for each other. They've been in the league a number of years, have had a lot of successes. Players and coaches.
Georgia scores to retake the lead. Nice finish by Jordan Hall. That is his fifth of the season, his second stint with Georgia.
Beautiful bounce shot by Jordan Hall. Another nice feed. Going away from the goal, Jameson was moving to his right, shot at backside. We got a nice reverse angle. Nice face dodge, hesitation. Again, anytime you can get Jameson to move, that's how you're gonna beat him. Straight on, he's very, very tough. Nice job by Jordan Hall. Beautiful shot over the top. Young players out there, bounce shot.
Jordan Hall up to 3 points on the day, two assists and a goal. He's one, rather two assists away from 500 in his career. Jordan Hall, 13 years in the NLL. He's the oldest player on the Georgia Swarm at 35 years old. He was a draft pick for the original New York team way back in 2007, also a product of Delaware, just like Brett Manning. They were both teammates for the Blue Hens.
Delaware's gonna have a good team this year. Been a little young the last couple of years. Great program.
A couple of rebound attempts on Jameson. He sticks with it. New England finally on top of the loose ball. Here's Ty Logan. The rookie scans the floor, decides to slow it down. Yeah, Delaware's gonna have a great season under Ben DeLuca, who has had prior history coaching the Team USA outdoor squad. Charlie Kitchen, look out for that name. An attackman who has a promising career also in box lacrosse. Resiteritz, he fumbles it. Georgia on the break, Swarm have a one goal lead. McIntosh flips it, now up top. Nice swim move here. Joel White regains. Georgia now puts its offense on the floor. There was a miscommunication. Some players weren't aware that White had the ball. Seven on the shot clock. Stotts scores. There you go, Randy Stotts. Scoreless last game and scoreless up until now. That's the first for Randy Stotts, and Georgia has built a two-goal lead.
Did a nice job using the blank as a screen. Shot across his body. Watch, he's gonna take his time. And great quick shot. That was a three-quarter shot. Caught Jameson off guard. I don't know if Jameson was ready for that. Maybe he didn't see it. But again, using that defender as a screen, nobody does it better.
So Georgia has scored now 5 goals, each goal scored by a different player now. Miller, Lyle Thompson, Jordan Hall, Shane Jackson, and Randy Stotts. So there you find some unselfishness because everyone's scoring the ball, but it seems that the aggressiveness has really tuned up a notch for Georgia.
Yeah, it looks like they're playing with more confidence. They really are moving the ball very well. They're active off ball. They're getting some good quality shots down low.
Swarm have scored 3 straight. Q spinning, outlets to O'Connor. His bounce shot is whisked away there by Poulin. Sellers has it now. Cody Sellers. Georgia may be looking to score here on the break. Blair gets tripped up. That was Miller. He gets drilled to the turf. Numbers for the Black Wolves. Creighton Reed around the pick. Shot score. Creighton Reed, 11 years in the NLL. First goal as a member of the New England Black Wolves.
Transition. New England's one of the better transition teams. Waits for the pick to get set. Uses the pick to get the shot off. We're gonna see the reverse angle. See the pick, nice job setting the pick, coming across the pick. As an offensive player, it's so important to wait for that pick to be set so you can use it, get around it, catch the goalie off guard. It's set as a screen.
I believe it was Watkinson who set the screen. Nice work there by Reed. It's funny because you look at Reed's numbers, no points, no shots coming into today. 13 loose balls, has played in all 5 games. When the Black Wolves had to make a choice to give Mackenzie Mitchell the healthy scratch, I asked Coach Glenn Clark, you know, what's Creighton Reed brought to the table? And not to say, you look at the numbers, you say, okay, well, what's he brought here? He doesn't have all this, the flashy loose ball stats. And he said he's been excellent. He's been super steady, a great veteran who does everything he's asked. He's in the right spot at the right time constantly. Great to see him get on the scoreboard.
Very smart player. We just saw he runs the floor very well. He probably should shoot the ball more if he's got the opportunity. He does have a good shot. We watched him in practice. The defense constantly working on their shots in practice.
Big opening for Stephen LeBlanc. That ball deflected up to Chad Tutton. Mishandled it. He tried to do it with one hand. 6 minutes to go in the first. Half, that is. Watkinson feeds to Crawford. It's a tough assignment defensively for Leo Sturris, who is draped all over Crawford. There is Wiedemann, who steps in to angle off the offensive player. Georgia back on offense.
Georgia likes to get the ball down low, especially in transition, and then look back for trailers. They do a really nice job.
Here's Lyle Thompson. He has 1 goal today. Jackson sets the screen. Hesitation for a moment. Georgia couldn't find anything. Jordan Hall was looking for another one. Brett Manning feeds it to Crawford. Double team quickly. Pounces on him. Up top it's O'Connor. Black Wolves set up. We're coming up on 5 minutes left, first half. At Mohegan Sun. Black Wolves, a historic start at 4-0. Georgia has lost 3 in a row, trying to stay afloat atop the East Division. Crawford, no-look pass. Resnitarits is stopped. Poulin standing on his head. Oh, what a bounce pass by Thompson. Jackson nearly cashed in. It is a treat to watch Lyle Thompson play. What a feed. Jackson just couldn't finish it off.
Big, big save by
Georgia's
Jameson.
Georgia's up 5-4, Jack.
Yeah, big, big save. Reed, first goal of the season, gets up the floor. Nice job waiting for the pick. Beautiful bounce shot down low.
Next weekend, the San Diego Seals are making history at hosting the Colorado Mammoth for the first NLL game to be played in Las Vegas. For more information, visit sealslax.com/Vegas. That is going to be something. It is on the eve of the Super Bowl this coming Saturday, February 1st. We weren't invited. I mean, we made our case a couple weeks ago. You ever see the movie The Hangover? They have the Wolf Pack. And, well, you know, there's one team in the NLL that has wolves on it. Just saying. But anyway, should be a great time. We'll check out and get an inside scoop on what the Colorado Mammoth and San Diego Seals are looking forward to for that big clash in Vegas next weekend. Preston Terrence around the pick, five to shoot, jump shot, rings off the pipe. Georgia ball.
Good effort by Resetarius to get that shot off. New England's getting in closer, getting better quality shots in tight. They need to do that to beat Poland. He's seeing everything very well from the outside.
Well, what's allowed for them, Jack, to get those opportunities?
Set picks up high, trying to open up the middle of the floor in front of the crease.
Adam Bomberry is trucked from behind. It's his first game back from injury.
I think you need to move the ball more, and they've done that the last 4 or 5 minutes of this game. They're doing a better job. Get more ball movement, more activity, off ball, side to side.
Q skips this ball, intended for Davey Emela. He was not aware. Callum Crawford is not on the floor. He gets a rest here for New England. Q off the screen, shot. It was deflected in front. Georgia hurries the other way. It's Wiedemann, 3-on-1 right now. Joel White fumbles it around. Here's White, the Syracuse product. He missed all of last year with injury. Former second round pick back in 2011. A rare second round pick you find on Georgia's roster. Tons of first round picks dating back to when the franchise was in Minnesota. Williams fires on the run. Nice duck there by Jamison to stop it. Doug Jamison is having another great game. He is approaching 20 saves in the half.
Over and back, call against Georgia. New England regains possession.
Stephen LeBlanc settles down. Crawford is back on the floor for this offensive set. LeBlanc off the pick. Poulin sits on it.
Yeah, that was a beautiful look by Resetarius. LeBlanc, great shot, but Poulin seeing the ball extremely well.
A little more methodical, it feels like, since that under five timeout. Both sides taking their time to read the defenses here. Here's Stotts off the Thompson pick. Jamison read it perfectly. Bops that ball away. The loose ball collected by Stotts. He settles the offense down, wants to reorchestrate. We approach 2 minutes to go in the half. One goal game, Georgia in front. Swarm losers of three straight. New England at 4-0, best start in franchise history. Spin move by Thompson. Finds Jackson, that's Hall, excuse me. Save Jamison. Oh, ball was deflected out, pardon me. Chaikowski rips it away.
You watch Stotts, he's so active off ball, uses his big body so well to open up space.
Manny.
Pick up ground balls.
Yeah, no doubt. Manny aiming for another transition goal. Black Wolves a little more, less shy to fire on the break. Something they haven't done the first four games of the season.
They need to continue to push the ball up the floor.
Minute 20 to go here in this first half. O'Connor screens off ball. Crawford waltzes, hits Q. Back over to O'Connor, five to shoot. Off the wall, New England sticks with it. They don't get a shot off. Coming up on NLL at the half, the Seals and Mammoth will make history. Again, they'll play their first ever game, the first ever game in NLL history in Las Vegas. We'll have highlights and analysis as well of the first half. Stay with us for NLL at the half.
that was actually Downing on offense. We saw, we thought it was Riley O'Connor. He stayed on offense.
Interesting, yeah, Downing is number eight. He's also a lefty, just like O'Connor. There is a 9-second differential between the game clock and the shot clock. Georgia taking its time to prevent New England from striking the other way. Thompson, it's Lyle, spins. Lyle flings it, stops with five to shoot. Backs down Tchaikovsky. BTB is denied. 10 seconds. And Georgia gets a timeout off. There we see a player calling the timeout in front of the official. So Georgia is going to draw up something. Well, we spoke on how important this game would be from the start. Philadelphia picked up a win on Friday against New York. Riptide 0-2 weekend after another loss last night. So there's separation between 1-3 and number 4, but things get really interesting. This is the first meeting of the season between Georgia and New England. These two teams don't meet again until March 27th when Georgia hosts the Black Wolves in Duluth, and then the second to last game of the season for Georgia is here in New England. The Black Wolves close the regular season against the Georgia Swarm on April 18th. This is Doug Jamison a moment ago. As we said, he's approaching 20 saves in this first half.
Beautiful shot by Stott behind the back, and Jamison there to make the stop. Love watching Stott's play. See how he uses his body to drive the defender close to the goal. Catches Jamison a little off guard, but able still to make the nice save. Stott is dangerous from anywhere on the floor, whether he's shooting behind the back, feeding the ball, loose ball guy, he does it all.
5 seconds for Georgia. They throw it down the floor. Black Wolves nearly convert. Georgia put the extra forward on the floor. And they almost beat the Swarm to tie the game. So Georgia escapes with a one-goal lead at halftime, 5-4. We didn't get a score over those final 7 minutes. So back and forth battle between New England and Georgia. So good stuff. Jordan Hall is standing alongside our own Robin Brown.
Jordan, you're all over the floor right now. One goal, 3 assists. How does the transition game feel to you right now?
Well, I think they're winning the transition game right now. We're doing a decent job 5-on-5. I'd like to see a few more shots 5-on-5 for us, but transition right now, our O guys got to get back there. They got at least two on us so far.
You guys were looking to come in here, have a hot start, but in terms of patience, how settled do you guys now feel out there?
Yeah, we had a tough start. I mean, we had a penalty right away, and then they were down two men right away. So it took us a little while to get in the flow. You know, we're starting to do that just now, but you know, in the second half, we want to come out and get that hot start that we were looking for at the beginning.
Thank you, Jordan.
No problem.
Brendan.
Thank you, Robin. Jordan Hall, the leader in points over the first 30 minutes with a goal and 3 assists. One goal game here at Mohegan Sun to wrap up week 9. Georgia up 5-4, trying to halt the 3-game losing streak. You're watching the NLL on VR Live. We'll be back. Welcome back to Mohegan Sun Arena. We're at the half, Black Wolves and Swarm for a crucial one in the East Division. The San Diego Seals and Colorado Mammoth will make history in the NLL when they play the first ever league game in Las Vegas next Saturday night. Devin Caney sat down with both teams to find out how Vegas became a lacrosse destination.
We talked about, you know, LA, we talked about a game in Anaheim, we talked about other market opportunities, and Vegas came up, it jolted the conversation that we wanted to have about, you know, a game outside the marketplace.
It's definitely going to be a monumental event. It's going to be something that, you know, that I think we're all going to remember forever, just being a part of it in that environment, in that city.
Vegas on Super Bowl weekend being one of the most popular destinations for sports fans, we thought that would be a really cool opportunity. And so that was where the idea was born.
I mean, it's the first professional lacrosse game, indoor lacrosse game, to be played in Vegas.
It's one that kind of jumps out at the schedule for you.
I don't think I've ever even thought about a pro game in Vegas.
And I think fans are going to love it, and then Vegas might turn into loving it too.
It'd be a pretty cool feeling just to be the first team to ever play there. And, you know, if there's ever expansion or a team that comes there full time, to know that we were kind of the ones to kickstart it would be a cool feeling. And just the opportunity to kind of go down to Vegas and you know, playing in an environment that I'm sure will be pretty wild down there. It'll be a lot of fun.
They're pushing the envelope, right, and trying to do things that haven't been done in this league. And you know, you're making ground, right, and you're creating you know, some buzz and excitement around the league.
Have the opportunity to play there, I think it's something that's pretty cool, pretty special, and something that once maybe a couple years down the road after everything's done, kind of look back and think about it. It'll be something that, I mean, I'll kind of reminisce on and talk about.
Unique experience for everybody, both teams. It's going to be a heated game against Colorado, so we're excited.
At the end of the day, it's another lacrosse game. It's an opportunity for us to get a win.
That we play Colorado because I thought, what a great opportunity. We're about halfway in between, you know, Vegas is halfway in between Colorado and San Diego.
The best players in the world don't get distracted. You know, they focus on them, they control the controllables, and they just move forward. And I think for young guys, that's, you know, a difficult task. I remember my first game in Colorado, and, you know, you look up, it's the big stage. And at the end of the day, you just have to go and execute your role and make that your priority and focus.
We're excited to be there. We're excited to have a good game, but we're going to treat it like any other game and make sure that we're prepared and hopefully we can get the win and then celebrate after.
It had some level of significance. It has a lot of significance for me personally, but at the end of the day, that wasn't about that. It was about the fact that this really made a ton of sense for a Western Division a matchup in Las Vegas and trying to get a lot of people in the National Lacrosse League to come join us.
Welcome back to Mohegan Sun Arena, NLL at the half. Georgia in front of New England, 5-4. Well, last week, the Black Wolves picked up a huge 8-7 overtime win. Our own Robin Brown recaps what was a special night here at Mohegan Sun.
In case you missed last week's game against Philadelphia, it was an overtime thriller. With the game tied at 7-7, we went to sudden death overtime.
We look ahead now to tonight, the game on the floor. It will be emotional because of the circumstances at the top of the division.
No question about it. Philadelphia beat New England twice last year, so I think there's a revenge factor. They're an expansion team, so Philly had New England's number last year. You got to win at home, too.
First place is on the line, New England and Philadelphia. 5-2 Philadelphia. What's New England going to do to get out of this funk and find some energy offensively? There's Crawford, buries it. Maybe that's the lift New England can use. Finds Reston Terrence, weaves through, and scores. We're going to overtime. Everybody holding their breaths here inside Mohegan Sun. Tied up at 7, next goal wins. Crawford to the house. Black Wolves win! Number 98 does the job.
The goal is going to be reviewed.
This one isn't over just yet. Here's Todd LeBranch.
Due to inconclusive evidence, the call on the field is confirmed.
New England wins. Black Wolves are 4-0 and have a game and a half lead for first place in the East Division.
Here for the Beer returns on February 1st as the New England Black Wolves take on the Vancouver Warriors. Fans can get samples from 10 local breweries. a t-shirt, and a ticket to the game for as low as $35.
Nice crowd on hand on this Sunday afternoon at Mohegan Sun Arena to wrap up week 9 in the NLL. Black Wolves down a goal to the Georgia Swarm, 5-4. Brendan Glasheen and former Boston Blazer Jack Piatelli. Robin Brown is also a member of our team. Great to be with you. So, a little back and forth. There were penalties early in the game that sort of quelled a bit in the second quarter. Still trying to get a feel for this one. Both teams, a bit of a rock fight as of right now.
Yeah, it hasn't been a really fast-paced game. I'd like to see more transition from New England, get the ball up the floor quicker, faster, maybe a little more patience on offense. They turned the ball over on being not patient enough, bad passes, turnovers you can't afford to have against this Swarm team who was so explosive on the offensive end of the floor.
Let's look at some stats from the first 30 minutes here at Mohegan Sun. Jordan Hall with a game best 4 points. He is just one assist away from 500 in his career. Callum Crawford held to just one goal. He's approaching 10 shots in the game. Andrew Q got off the schneid with the first goal of the game for New England. So that is good to see. Again, Crawford's got 6 shots on one goal. Resiteritz has the next most with 6 of his own. Well, we discussed coming into this game, New England has a chance here, Jack, to really create separation in the East Division with a head-to-head win against Philadelphia last week. Now, Philly has done a nice job rebounding from that loss with a win on Friday night. Black Wolves can really separate from Georgia. It's the first meeting of the season between New England and Georgia. Swarm in jeopardy of losing their 4th straight should they not hold on today. Last year, Georgia didn't lose its 4th game of the season until February 16th. So this is uncharted ground for the Georgia Swarm. New England, again, has a real chance here to separate.
No question about it. In any team, these 3 teams play against each other, it's going to be a tight contest. They can beat anyone, anytime, depending upon their offense, goaltending. Comes down to goaltending, loose balls, transition game. But on paper, these teams are pretty even all the way through.
No question. Georgia plus 4 in the loose ball category at half, 30-26. Joe Nardella won 6 of 10 faceoffs. Jordan McIntosh, 5 of 11. And just another note on Georgia as far as the schedule is concerned. The Swarm go to Philadelphia on Friday night this coming week. Then they get 2 weeks off post-New York. So with the New York loss last week, a heartbreaker, 13-12, 4 consecutive games for the Swarm against the East Division. Got to take care of those games. And again, New England and Georgia don't meet again until March 27th. That game is in Duluth. Black Wolves score to tie it at 5 to kickstart the second half. Riley O'Connor from the left side. That's his first.
Well, this goal started with Malcolm picking up the loose ball on the faceoff. Resiteris finding Riley O'Connor for a beautiful bounce shot, quick shot. Good way to start the second half. Caught Poulin by surprise. Really nice look. Here we see the reverse angle. Used the defender as a screen, shot right over the top. Beautiful bounce shot. Finish for Riley O'Connor.
One of those set plays that Glenn Clark told us for a left-hander. New England used that right away earlier. Nardella bidding for a faceoff goal. Well, we saw Andrew Q score right away in the first quarter. New England comes out of the break, sets up that offensive strike. So I guess composure is a big element too. When Georgia throws wrinkles at you defensively, the Black Wolves still have to stay true to their stuff offensively.
Continue to stay in your offense, continue to move the ball, believe in what you're doing, spread the ball around, continue to try and push the ball off the floor.
You saw a moment ago Riley O'Connor, his 10th goal of the season, had one goal last week against Philadelphia. In the home opener, he scored a career-high 6 goals. Crawford off the catch. He fired, missed it wide. Rest of Terrence, the dunk attempt, and it's reeled in. Nice defense by Georgia. They are there to rescue Mike Poulin. That was the rookie, Kaysen Tarbell, the first-round pick of Georgia, coming out of Cornell. Off the pick, on the run, it's Stotts. He misses. Here comes Malcolm. He scored one goal in transition already, 3-2. Malcolm uses the defense as a screen, doesn't fire. Now Malcolm goes, fires, save, Poulin.
Probably would have liked to see Malcolm pull that out and get the offense on.
Malcolm has the one goal, of course, and 3 loose balls at recess. Lyle Thompson held the one goal in the first half. He's had a quiet day. Bounce shot stops. It's deflected by Jameson underneath the goal. Right now, Georgia does not have a goalie in between the pipes, contending to possibly use that extra forward. Ball is whistled dead.
Looks like Downing's going to go out for holding for New England.
Let's get the call from the official.
New England penalty number 8, minor penalty holding the stick.
Just the second penalty against the Black Wolves. Downing serves it, so Georgia is on the power play for the second time. Again, Georgia reps the number 1 power play in the NLL at 61% entering today. Swarmer 1-for-1. It was Shane Jackson who scored it. Stotts fires. Nice slide by Jameson, makes the stop. Georgia sticks with possession. Miles Thompson into Stotts. Misfired the pass to Jackson. Jordan Hall to Lyle. Lyle Thompson, a slingshot. Saved by Jameson.
Great overhead look. Saved by Jameson. What the Swarm do so well is they make that extra pass to get that better quality shot. Most of the times it's inside, especially on their power play.
Well, that's the unselfishness, that Coach Colmo is really pleased with at times, but then sometimes he says, guys, you gotta take a shot when you're open. Talk to us about that before the game today. New England just flings it up there with 1 on the clock. It was close. Poulin camped under to make the grab. Under a minute to go in this power play. We're tied up at 5. Riley O'Connor, the equalizer, to launch the third quarter. Can the Black Wolves continue this historic start? One of 2 unbeaten teams in the NLL. Lyle Thompson, his shot is disrupted from behind.
Watkinson did a nice job to get a stick on Thompson's shot. Make the shot go wide.
Adam Bomberry again, fresh legs. His first game of the season. After missing the first 4 due to injury, he's barreled from behind. A few players lose their sticks. Georgia possession. 15 seconds to go in the power play. Swarm 1-for-1 in this spot. Here's Zach Miller to Jackson. 2-man game. Miller up top. It stops. That ball ricocheted off the crossbar, but it bounced out, did not cross the goal line.
And after it hit the crossbar, it looked like it hit Jameson and almost went back in.
New England catches a break, even strength, but Georgia's on the run. Sellers flips it to Miles Thompson. Jakowski doing his best defensively. Now it's Lyle, Ground ball, fluttering, picked up by Jackson. In tight, Lyle, fake, scores. Great hesitation moves by Lyle Thompson. That's his 2nd of the game, and Georgia retakes the lead 6-5.
Beautiful the way he slipped inside. Stayed out of the crease, and there was like 1 second left in the shot clock. He handles the ball as well as anybody in tight. Reverse angle, little face dodge, another face dodge. Able to pull the stick across his body and find the upper part of the net. You know, moving Jameson all over allowed him to get the goal.
So Lyle Thompson is the first player today to have multiple goals. His second, up to 15 on the season, tied for a team high. The MVP from 3 years ago, Lyle Thompson.
New England was called for over and back. They had possession. Ball goes back to the swarm. Costly error by New England.
With a one goal lead, Georgia looking to add on. Outside shot. Nice snag by the Black Wolves on that ground ball. Downing up top to John LaFontaine. Inserts to Crawford.
Another loose ball by Malcolm. Come up with a number of them throughout this game on the faceoffs and defensively. Does a lot of little things.
Crawford receives it back. Fakes the jump shot, rests to tear it, save Poulin. Q pounces on the loose ball. Finds Crawford, he barks out the play call, a head nod to move a player. Q sets the screen, Crawford weak side. They couldn't find him.
Very good look, just wasn't able to connect to Crawford. I like the look.
Crawford had a total of 5 shots at halftime, 7 shots, 1 goal. On the run, Miles Thompson missing wide. That ball pops out of bounds. That leads to a stoppage on the floor. Georgia has a 1-goal lead here at Mohegan Sun. The Swarm trying to end a 3-game losing streak. We'll be back for more NLL on. The NLL on BR Live is brought to you by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Visit geico.com to see how much you could save. Brendan Glasheen and Jack Piatelli. Do you have dance moves like those guys?
I'm too old to have dance moves like that.
Oh, come on.
Never had dance moves in my life.
You know, when we're off the air, you always talk about how you look good for an older guy. So now when you're on the air, you're going to use the old card?
I am.
Okay.
Thanks for bringing it up.
No problem. Happy to do it. Happy to be here. George is ahead 6-5. We're wrapping up week 9 in the NLL. It's Hunter, the mascot's birthday, so all of the local mascots in Connecticut have come to celebrate. New England in the midst of a franchise best. 4-0, trying to go to 5-0 to be one of 2 unbeaten teams in the league. Down a goal. Crawford ties it up. That's the second for Callum Crawford. And once again, at Mohegan Sun, we're tied.
Yeah, Callum did a nice job getting up high. No one was playing him off ball. Great look like LeBlanc. And he's deadly. Can't leave him open like that off ball. We know he's one of the best scorers in this game. And because he's one of the best shooters from anywhere.
The 35-year-old in his 15th season, hungry for a championship. And right now his team is battling with a team that's given them problems over the years. Georgia has taken 2 out of 3 against New England in each of the last 2 seasons. Both squads, though, lost in the first round of the NLL playoffs last year. New England falling to Buffalo. Georgia lost against Toronto. Tied at 6, 8 minutes to go in the third. Joel White spins out of traffic. He's still in traffic. Zips it out to Thompson. We've had several ties and lead changes in this game. We're in for a thriller. We had 3 games that were excellent last night in the National Lacrosse League. Shaping up to be another great game here this afternoon at Mohegan.
Just seems like when New England's down, they never seem to give up. They really believe in what they're doing on the offensive end, and having Doug Jamison in goal, they're always in the game.
No panic. Off that missed shot by O'Connor. Numbers here for Georgia, it's Sellers. Jamison bops that ball all the way into the stands.
And Crawford was a defender.
on that 3-on-1.
Still swarm ball, shot clock reset. Shane Jackson, the lefty, swings it. In tight, Zach Miller aiming to pick up his own miss. Dougie Jameson the save. Colton Watkinson the other way. Third member of our team, Robin Brown, has more on this Black Wolves defense.
Well, Brendan, the Black Wolves holding Georgia to just one goal in this quarter. And when I sat with New England's defensive coordinator yesterday, well, I guess we don't need to talk about defense right now. I'll send it up to you to talk about that goal for offense first.
Jordan Durston, Robin, with the score. But hey, defense creates offense. Durston with his first goal here at Mohegan. He's got four now on the season.
I believe that was Q with the assist. Finds the lane to cut. Defenseman had to make a decision, take the ball, or the man cutting. Left Durston open, beautiful bounce shot to take the lead. That all started with Jameson's outlet. One of the best goaltenders when he makes the save. Quality outlet passes to the transition guys to get the offense in position to make plays like we just saw.
So it's 7-6. Robin, back down to you.
Thanks, Brendan. When I did have that conversation with New England's defensive coordinator, he told me that he stressed two things this week. One, you have to protect the middle when you're facing Georgia. And two, you have to make sure that that communication is constant. And right now, holding Georgia just one goal in this quarter, it looks like they're doing just that. Brendan?
That's a tall task, Robin, after allowing three goals in the second to this swarm team. Georgia has been a bit uncharacteristic offensively in terms of league ranks. Offense fourth in the league coming in, and Coach Clem DeRozio speaking highly of this Georgia team. The whole league does, but just the amount of talent, and you can't just focus on one guy for Georgia on both the left and right side of the forward position. So many guys can beat you. New England so far has done a decent job holding some of them in check. Lyle Thompson has two goals. He's the only multi-goal scorer of those forwards. Durston weaves through. Lost sight of the shot clock. It went down, a violation.
Good ball movement side to side for New England. I like what I see. They just ran out of time.
Here's Hall, finds Jackson. Stomps on the brakes, kicks out Lyle Thompson. Great D here from Adam Bomberry. Checking with his stick, and now there's a penalty being called against Bomberry. Oh, no penalty.
No possession. It was a push called on Bomberry. Did not have possession, therefore, no penalty.
Loose ball push. So we approach 5 minutes to go in the third. Swim move by Hall. Kicks it out. Jameson read that shift perfectly. Miles Thompson is stopped. New England has the lead after consecutive goals. Crawford and Durston. Jackson curling. Brett Manny draped all over him. It's Hall's turn, the longtime veteran. Jackson, nowhere to go. Coach DeRozio's gotta be happy about this defense right now with four to shoot. Diving attempt by Jameson. That ball was well wide, and that leads to a stoppage on the floor.
This was a beautiful goal, and look, you got Q to Durston to take the lead. Continue to move the ball, you're gonna get.
Glenn Clark doing his best to stay composed in what is another tight game here at Mohegan Sun Arena. Black Wolves have a one goal lead, 7-6. Leads have been hard to come by. It feels anytime New England ties the game, Georgia's had a response. So that goal from Durston might be the lift New England needed.
Yes, and this possession is a big one for New England. We've got 4 minutes left in this third period, so every possession is going to become more and more important for both teams as the game progresses.
We certainly learned that last Saturday night when Philadelphia was in the building. 8-7 final in overtime. Black Wolves undefeated, just like Halifax, at 4-0. Georgia has lost 3 in a row, losing its grip in the standings in the East. And there's a stinger from Shane Jackson off a beautiful feed from right to left. Jackson the finish. We're tied at 7.
The Swarm do it better than most teams in the NLL. Like to swing the ball from side to side. And Jackson, one of the best shooters. How quick he's able to get the shot off for a beautiful finish to tie the game.
It was Zed Williams who hit him in the perfect spot to rip that ball through.
That pass was on a rope, not much room to get that pass through to Jackson's stick, but he was ready to catch it, handle, and get it off quickly.
Shane Jackson entered today tied for second in the NLL in goals. He's up to 17 with 2 today. Georgia strips it from the Black Wolves. 3.5 to go, third quarter, even at 7.
Georgia does an outstanding job putting pressure on the Winglands. Clear when they get the ball on defensive floor, they move it up the floor. They really make it very difficult for New England to get the ball on the offensive end. One of the best teams in the league to put pressure on the defenders when they're in the transition guys when trying to get the ball on the offensive end.
Steph in the block, curls off a couple of picks, and he scores. That is a goal. First of the game for Stephen LeBlanc. The lefties have found rhythm here for the Black Wolves in the third, 8-7 New England.
Looked like Poland maybe definitely misplayed this shot. It was a bounce shot. It hit him and rolled over him and went in the goal. LeBlanc is a big guy, got topside of his defender. Because he got topside, he had the whole lane and space to get the shot off. Sometimes you get lucky when you shoot, but the more you shoot and you get your shot on goal, the better chance you're gonna score. And that's a perfect example of just getting your shot on goal.
LeBlanc is truly a silent leader for this New England team. Whenever he doesn't get the numbers he normally is accustomed to, he's silent, he picks up loose balls, stays active even when the ball is not in his stick. He has 3 loose balls on the day. That's, as you saw, his 5th goal of the season, first of the game. 8-7 Black Wolves. Georgia looking to tie things up. Jordan Hall has already eclipsed 500 career assists today. There's a delayed penalty. Miller, who fires, and now will get the penalty here against New England.
Looks like it's going to be a hold on New England. On Logan.
New England penalty, 2 minutes holding.
Looked like he tied up Thompson's stick while he was defending him. Yeah, he's holding with his right hand. Off ball.
So for the third time, Georgia on the power play, 1-for-2 in the game so far. Nice outlet up the floor. Watkinson, stop, pop, score! Waved off. He is furious. Watkinson running to his bench to challenge this call. He thought he had a score.
Quick look at it, looked like he did. Took the shot, we got a red flag, we got a challenge, Coach Clark. But just taking a quick look at it live, like we just saw it, looked like the ball crossed the crease before he went in the, Watkinson went in the crease.
Oh, that's a goal.
Reverse angle, we're gonna take a look at the reverse angle. Nice job to stay in the air. Definitely crossed
the goal line before he landed in the crease from what I can see. Brendan, what did you see?
I saw that left foot not touch the crease when the ball was out of that stick.
Very important challenge because we've got 1:42 left in this game. New England will add to their lead.
Okay, show me the from behind.
Whether it was a goal or not.
Okay. Play through.
Look at the net.
Okay, and then what's anything else?
Goal.
Show me the other two. Right here.
Ball.
I want to see this one.
The crease.
Okay, play through.
He landed. It wasn't even close.
Yep, play through. Thank you. After review, the ball crosses the line prior to the shooter coming down. Call on the field is overturned. Good goal.
So the call is reversed. New England goal, and that is crucial. For the first time today, the Black Wolves have a two-goal lead.
Watkinson came running off the floor, yelling and screaming at his coaches. He knew for sure that that was a goal. He was very confident, and he was right. Great call by Coach Clark to throw the flag, have it reviewed. Black Wolves up by two.
Nice feed up the floor here by White.
Nardella came up with the face-off ground ball, but he was swarmed by three Georgia players and was forced to make a bad pass and a turnover.
We're approaching a minute to go in this third quarter. New England again, for the first time today, a two-goal lead. Georgia, 40 seconds to go in the power play. On the door. New England trying to rip that ball away. Swarm stick with it, 45 seconds. 22 on the shot clock.
Donnie
Lyle Thompson is on it.
Yeah, Donnie once again gets his stick in the shooting lane.
Shot clock violation, another for Georgia, fifth of the day.
Great defensive series by New England. We saw a big save by Jamison early in that offensive series for the Swarm. 21 seconds left in the period. New England has pulled Jamison to get an extra player on. We're gonna see 6-on-5 for about 14 seconds.
Crawford weaves through. Didn't get a shot off, 2 seconds. The dunk by Resiteritz, nothing goes. So we've reached the end of three at Mohegan Sun Arena. Black Wolves, a two-goal lead for the first time today. They'll look to hold on to this one as we make the turn for home. Transition goal, Colton Watkinson. We'll be back for the fourth quarter. This is the NLL on BR Live. Seven Black Wolves as we enter the fourth quarter. New England trying to stay atop the East Division with an unblemished record, 4-0 this season. New England trying to be one of two teams that stay undefeated through week 9, Halifax the other. If you love the NLL, you'll love all the highlights on our social channels. Get the best goals, saves, and action during the games and during the week on Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, and NLL.com. Brendan Glasheen and Jack Piatelli. Robin Brown is on the floor. Two-goal game. New England's lefties have really made an impact down the stretch. LeBlanc, of course, with a goal. Durston, a forward with a goal. And another transition goal, Colton Watkinson.
Yeah, they've done a nice job moving the ball side to side on offense. And actually, the last goal that Callum Crawford scored by moving that ball to the left side opened him up for a beautiful shot from the outside. They need to continue to move the ball side to side. It's going to open up more opportunities, not only for the left side, but the right side.
Fourth quarter is underway.
New England's on a power play. Hutton is in the penalty box for 2 minutes holding.
Black Wolves have had some success on the power play today with two goals in this spot. On the reset, it's Q up top, manning this unit. Preston Terrence to Q. He loves that spot up top. Second goal for the rookie. Black Wolves have built a three-goal lead.
Great patience by New England. Great execution, moving the ball around. And like you said, Brendan, that's his spot, Q spot. Finds the open net to take a three-goal lead. I love the way he shoots the ball over the top. Tough for a goaltender to find that ball when it comes over the top. Number of different release points when you shoot the ball over the top. And we're finding out very quickly in this season, Q is a very good shooter from outside.
So New England has scored 5 of the last 6 goals. When you go back and look, New England was trailing 6-5 to Georgia. Much needed response for the Swarm. Second finish for Randy Stotts.
Able to sneak into the inside. So talented, great hands. Nice handle and finish by Stotts. We're gonna take a look at it. Zed Williams with the assist. But what Stotts did on that play, it looked like he was gonna go set a pick. Instead of sending a pick, he slipped in between the two defenders. Got to the open space inside. And Williams, a beautiful feed to Stotts.
So Georgia is within two. Resiteritz looking for the roller a moment ago. That was LeBlanc, rather Durston. Resiteritz screen, shot, missed wide for Callum Crawford. Georgia sticking with it. Jameson slid in the nice spot. We're more than 90 seconds into the quarter. Watkinson slows down. Jack, at this point in the game, for New England, how do you balance staying aggressive with the lead but also staying true to your principles on defense? Not being passive, I guess, is what I mean to say.
New England has done a nice job getting on the Swarm's hands on the outside. What they've haven't done very well in the last couple of series is allowing the Swarm to get open on the inside. They got to eliminate the inside, continue to put pressure on the outside, and they'll be okay.
Swarm settle it down. Down two goals. Jump shot. Jordan Hall stopped. Downing with the BTB flip up the floor. Creighton Reed has one today. New England kind of finding the flame that lit them up last year. Transition goals. Crawford fakes the jump shot on the doorstep, flings it wide. Georgia comes back the other way. Joel White looking good for the Swarm. Again, missed most of last season due to injury. Beautiful finish, Miles Thompson. Off the pick, and suddenly we have a one-goal game again here at Mohegan Sun.
Dangerous offensive team. They can score a number of goals in minutes. Was able to pick up the loose ball, get a quick shot off. Beats Jamison, low far side. Very well placed shot by Miles Thompson. This game may come down to the last possession.
Well, Jack, it certainly has a feel to that. No question. So after New England built a three-goal lead, the largest on either side, Georgia has shrinked the deficit to one. Crawford fakes the windup, decides to step back and let the offense trickle in. Crawford has two goals in the game. O'Connor to Crawford, dumps it to Q, has both goals today on the power play. Crawford steps through Jason Noble's shot, misses wide. Shot clock runs out. And New England's 3-for-4 on the power play. We talked about the battle of special teams. New England has won that battle, taking advantage of the penalties. Andrew Q has executed nicely on both ends. Jamison stops Lyle Thompson.
He's so good keeping that stick between his legs. Showed how strong he is with that stick between his legs and being able to hold that stick while the shot tries to come through.
Krepinsek fires. He gets bodied. Nice check by the Black Wolves to prevent a high percentage look. Doug Jamison has 33 saves coming off a 50-save effort against Philadelphia, the second most of his career. He had 55 last year in a loss to Rochester on the road. Poulin is doing his best on the other end. He's got 29 saves. Jason Tarbell slows up. Georgia ignites its offense, down a goal. Two straight for the Swarm. Jackson dumps it, stops into Zed Williams. Took his eyes off the ball for a moment, had a chance to regather, but he was surrounded by the Wolfpack. Get a penalty here against Durston? Nardella.
Yeah, Nardella's gonna go off for holding. Off ball. He's not happy.
New England penalty number 91, minor elbow.
Oh, I'm sorry, elbow. Got his elbow at high. I didn't see it because it was off ball. I'm gonna take another look. Tough call. Didn't look like the elbow got up high.
So Georgia has a real shot to tie it up. Swarm today, 1-for-4 on the, one for three on the power play. Thompson regathers. Nice look at the power play from up top.
I can see why Nadella was upset. I've seen worse penalties called.
And now there's traction going against Georgia.
Randy Stotts is gonna go off for holding. He's not happy with the call.
483, minor penalty, holding.
So for the next minute 17, we'll get 4-for-4. New England by one, 10-9. You can't do that, Randy Stotts. When we come back, we got a good finish coming. Black Wolves in Bruges, the perfect combo. New England will face Vancouver on Saturday, February 1st at 7 o'clock. Special packs include a ticket to the game, t-shirt, and entry into our post-game beer garden where you can sample local brews. Head to blackwolves.com for details. Should be a fun night. The Vancouver Warriors coming to town. New England has its mind on closing out Georgia. Just a one-goal game. One-goal lead for New England. Up the floor, it's Jordan McIntosh. He feeds, shot, score! We're tied! Shane Jackson has a hat trick in every game this season. He comes through for the Swarm, 10-10.
Transition game, 4-on-4, opens up the floor. A lot of space to play with. Jackson finds the open space and finishes to tie the game. Good patience by McIntosh. We're going to see it again. Gets his defender to draw. Nice dump to Jackson for the finish.
Shane Jackson, 6 games, 3 goals in each. 6 times 3 is 18. Mr. Consistency for this Georgia Swarm team.
No question about it.
Well, as you said, Jack, when the third quarter got started, as the game continues to unfold, each and every possession becomes that more crucial.
And it seems like this game has really picked up in terms of the balls moving up and down the floor more often than early in the game. We're seeing more transition.
Georgia is +8 in the loose ball battle, 55-47. Joe Nardellis had a lot of success after a slow start on the faceoff dot. He's 17 of 22. Under 9 to go, Georgia, New England, tied up at 10. Black Wolves undefeated at 4-0, trying to stay atop the East with an unblemished record. Georgia has lost 3 straight, trying to stay in the race, in jeopardy of falling out of it very early in the season. Jameson making another stop. He's up to 38 saves.
Another possession for the Swarm.
Lyle Thompson delivers. Jameson knocks it away.
New England's going to be on the power play. They go on the power play for 44 seconds now.
Nardella enters the floor. We'll see if New England makes a change. He's going to stay on to play defense. He's guarding Thompson. 30 seconds in the power play. Nardella on top of Thompson. Shuffles to his right. Gives it up, looking for Stotts. Or check that, Zed Williams. Nardella pounces on the loose ball. New England can get one final shot off on the power play here. 10 seconds. Tied up at 10. Georgia with 3 straight to even the score. In front, bouncer rings off the post.
Fantastic save by Poulin on Riley O'Connor. That was a good look. Very good shot.
On the run, Stephen LeBlanc is stopped. Georgia has numbers going the other way. That shot misses wide. Totten comes away with it. Randy Stotts flips it back out to McIntosh. To the lefty entering Jackson. Beautiful flip in front to Miles Thompson. Doesn't get a shot. Underneath to Jordan Hall. Ball skitters to the right of Jameson. Watches that ball gaze by him. Out of play. We're under 7 minutes to go.
The Swarm have done a nice job getting extra possessions after they take a ball, a shot, whether it's off a rebound, the goalie, or off the boards, doing a nice job getting extra possessions in this period.
Poulin lobs it ahead. Wiedemann got it in deep to Hall. Wiedemann hustles for that loose ball. Black Wolves scrap it away. Still tied up at 10. New England built a 3-goal lead, 10-7. Georgia tying it. Stotts, Miles Thompson, Shane Jackson. all within a 5 minute span. Crawford sends it to O'Connor in front, rested Terrence. That ball almost squirts by. Poulin's on top of it, it's inside of his pads.
Good series, good ball movement for New England. Another quality shot by Rhett Terrence.
Off the pick, outside shot. Zach Miller off the mark. Fight for the loose ball, Zed Williams somehow plows it out. Great play by Williams to keep the possession alive.
The Swarm have done a fantastic job finding the loose ball after a shot, like I said. Continue to have extra possessions. Defense cannot come off the floor. Opportunity to wear him down.
Stott sets the screen. Lyle Thompson onto the doorstep, does not see an angle. New England's defense has been terrific. Stotts backpedals, fires, save off the right arm of Jamison. Zed Williams again with the loose ball. Georgia taking more time off the clock. Much more strategy now as regulation is under 5 minutes. Stotts, another save, Doug Jamison. New England on top of the loose ball. It's Ty Logan, the rookie.
Jamison coming up big in that series.
Just the opposite defensively for Georgia, remaining very aggressive. Krepinsek all on top of the transition man. 4.5 to go, 10 on the shot clock. Resetarits to Durston. Now it's LeBlanc. Scans the defense, 4 to shoot for LeBlanc. Flips it, Resetarits got one off. It's a violation, ball is nowhere near the cage. So we step aside for the final time here at Mohegan Sun. Tied at 10, a crucial East Division game at stake. Jordan McIntosh finding Shane Jackson. Tied at 10. It's now time for the Geico play of the game. This goal had to get reviewed, Jack, but another transition finish for New England. Colton Watkinson with great creativity to put this in.
Did a great job to stay up in the air before he landed in the crease, allowing the ball to cross the goal line. They originally called it a no goal. The officials, they reviewed it, reversed the call.
New England's had 3 transition goals today. That was often a recipe for them to win games last year. Malcolm has one, Watkinson, as we just witnessed, and Creighton Reed with the other. So what's this gonna come down to now? 4:18 to go, we're tied up at 10.
Good possessions. You know, eliminate the repossessions on shots by the Swarm. They've done a really nice job having long possessions, meaning they'll have 2 or 3 possessions after the original shot. They gotta get the ball up the floor quicker, get their offense on the floor.
Downing is just getting harassed right now, trying to get the ball back. Georgia resets. They've done a nice job of that the last few minutes to recycle possessions.
Aggressive on defending. The defensive players from New England trying to clear the ball up the floor.
Backdoor, Randy Stotts was looking for Jackson. New England has numbers the other way. Tony Malcolm up to Crawford. The rest of the unit flows in out the back door. Georgia has lost 3 in a row. They haven't done that in 4 years. This is uncharted territory for the Swarm. In jeopardy of falling out of the East Division race, New England looking to stay unblemished. Resetarits is stopped by Poulin. Ball bops out though behind the goal line. Crawford steps into one. Another stop. Loose ball. Sellers is there. Under 3 minutes to play. Both teams this season have played just one-goal game. That was last week. Georgia lost to New York in regulation down the stretch, and New England beat Philadelphia in overtime. Off the rebound. Stotts Almost like Lyle Thompson meant to put it off the board. Manny is getting sandwiched as he tries to scrape for that loose ball. Jordan Hall is in there. Zed Williams again for the Swarm. It's Georgia ball.
Their offensive players doing an outstanding job putting pressure on the ball.
Jackson misses wide. There's no question, Georgia's forwards are some of the best in the league at not just the talent they bring to the table, but the intangibles as well.
Lyle Thompson being one of them.
Lyle was a leader in loose balls a few years ago in the NOL. Q looks to dump it, less than 2 minutes to play. Durston to Ressa Terrence, scans the defense, scooping around. That was LeBlanc. Durston on the goal line, fires off the pipe.
Nice job by Durston to get the shot off. Off Coolant. Oh, but they're calling it George's ball. Maybe he shot it after the shot clock went off.
Tied up at 10. On the run, it's Thompson. Another loose ball to Georgia. They've had so many second chance opportunities in this fourth quarter. New England once led 10-7, three straight goals to tie it for the Swarm. Stotts fires, save Jameson.
The wing guys for the Swarm, goal line extended, are getting inside position on the rebounds, coming up with the rebound.
We haven't had a goal in 8 minutes here in the fourth. 1 minute left, shot clock resets. Miles Thompson stopped. Got the loose ball back. It stops. Misses. Tug Jameson is putting this team on his back once again.
He seems to get better as the game goes on.
So I believe New England got a timeout off.
Stotts all alone in front of the goal, missed. But he stepped in the crease, possession. New England. New England calls a timeout. Gonna take a second look. Reverse angle. Nice behind the back pass by Thompson. Great opportunity for Stotts.
Can't ask for a better look.
No, and he doesn't miss getting his shot on goal, never mind not score.
Doug Jameson with 40 saves. Callum Crawford runs up the floor. There's about a 30-second differential shot and game clock. New England pulled through in the clutch last week. Shot by Q, misses wide. Crawford scored the game winner in overtime against Philadelphia. Loose ball, a bunch of yellow jerseys. It's Georgia. Week 9 in the NOL has been terrific. Three great games last night, and we get a thriller to close out this Sunday. And now Ed Cuomo, he wants to chat with his group on offense. Timeout Georgia, and the shot clock is up. Hey fans, next week, don't forget the NLL Game of the Week is moving to Las Vegas. Connor Fields and the Seals host Dylan Ward and the Mammoth at Orleans Arena. Catch all the action on BR Live, Twitter and Facebook starting at 9:30 p.m. Eastern with a special half-hour edition of NLL Game Day Live. That is a great game to feature in Week 10. We still have Week 9 action going on. Jack tied up at 10. Shot clock gets reset to 21 seconds. 29 and a half on the game clock for Georgia.
There, can I see a clock? Okay. Back, back, keep going back. 22, time. So, put, can you put two? Is there a game clock? So go back, two, okay, go back. Okay, back, back, back. I want to see when I start to blow my whistle. Yeah, right here. So keep going. Now, I want 22 seconds on the clock.
Yes, we can do that.
On the, sorry, 22 seconds on the shot clock.
Yeah.
Okay, 22 seconds on the shot clock.
And the game clock.
And the game clock stays.
Yeah.
All right, so we just got word from our crew chief is Ryan Fowler, assistant referees Matt Garrison and Kyle Crawford. Shot clock is now at 22 seconds. It was at 21 a moment ago. What's the game plan for Georgia here?
You got to get in a hot hand, look for Stotts or Jackson. Obviously, Lyle Thompson is a threat. They've had a lot of luck getting the ball inside. Probably start the ball up high and get some cutters in low. Jamison's done a nice job seeing the shots from outside. Defensively for New England, they've got to remain aggressive on ball.
New England does have one timeout left. We'll see how long Georgia takes the clock down. Tied at 10, week 9 wrapping up in the NLL. Georgia's lost 3 in a row. Can they put the losing streak to bed? Around the pick, it's Jordan Hall. Now it's Randy Stotts. Lyle Thompson sets the screen. 1 second to shoot. Stotts didn't get a shot off. He didn't look at the clock. He couldn't believe it. And New England gets a timeout off with 5.9 to go. They might add a little bit of time. Not much, but a little bit. Randy Stotts was not aware of the shot clock.
Maybe because it started at 22, he thought it was 30, but to your point, he was not aware of the shot clock winding down. If he knew if it was winding down, he would have taken that shot.
As we've discussed all afternoon, this one is pivotal, more so for the Georgia Swarm. 2-4 puts you in a big hole. And look, for those of you still trying to refresh yourselves and get up to speed with the new NLL playoff format, the top two in each division make the postseason. Then there's two wild card teams. So this is huge. Let's look again at, let's see if Stotts does not have his eyes on the shot clock.
And that's very rare for Stotts. Always well aware of the game situation. And give credit to New England's defense stopping the Swarm in terms of getting a good quality shot off.
So the clock read 5.9 as of the timeout. A few more seconds put up there. 7.5. Now with New England having possession, the final possession of the game, there is no man in the goal. So 6 forwards against 5. Tied at 10. Here comes New England. Up the floor, Malcolm finds LeBlanc in front. That ball's chopped off. Georgia did not get it off. Either way, that ball is wide. And for the second straight weekend here at Mohegan Sun Arena, overtime is needed.
Well, we knew we were going to have a competitive game. Didn't know it would go into overtime. Both teams' goaltenders have played extremely well. Defensively, it's been a good defensive battle.
We'll step aside for a minute or so. Tied at 10. New Well, for the fans that made their way to Mohegan Sun Arena on this Sunday afternoon, they are witnessing a treat. We are going to overtime. New England had 7.5 seconds down the stretch. LeBlanc had his pass intercepted. So that means we need extra time. Again, it's sudden death overtime of the National Lacrosse League. Next goal wins.
This faceoff, McIntosh, Nadella, gonna be very important to start this overtime period.
Nardella has now won 18 of 23 faceoffs today. He has totally outmastered McIntosh. Malcolm gets bodied. Georgia hunting for that loose ball. Swarm have it back. New England's defense gets back on the floor. Now the forwards spill in for Georgia. First overtime game of the season for the Swarm. New England, back-to-back games needing overtime. Jackson throws this ball to Stotts. It's Lyle Thompson, spinning, firing, missing. 7 seconds to shoot, no reset. Here comes Jordan Hall, flips it up top. Zach Miller, the rookie, save Jamison. Callum Crawford accepts the feed. We're tied at 10, a minute into overtime. Can the Black Wolves remain undefeated 4-0 as week 9 winds down? Georgia's lost 3 in a row. Here comes Crawford. Can he do it again? Spinning. Crawford, can he be the hero? Bounce shot, save, Poulin. Amala bodies him out. Georgia hops on the loose ball, flings it to the mid part of the floor, and said Williams. Williams fires, misses. He took a shot with none of his forwards on the floor with him.
Not a quality, good decision on his part to take that shot in overtime.
Tchaikovsky hands off to Crawford. Zed Williams gave it a rip, it didn't work out. Now it's Riley O'Connor directing traffic. Off the pick, it's Q. Zings it, Crawford to the middle of the floor. In front, there was a nice look for Resiterence. Four to shoot for Resiterence, down to three. His outlet disrupted. So it's Georgia possession. Clock stops, 12:57. Again, sudden death overtime, folks. Next goal wins. Jackson has three goals today. Up top, Jordan Hall, off the pick. Hall fakes the swim move, skips it. It stops, spinning, stops, outlets. Thompson is open, fakes, fires. Broken up, Jameson saves it.
Great check on Thompson by Downing to get the ball out of his stick when he was trying to take a shot. You gotta give both defensive units a lot of credit, putting a lot of pressure on the ball, not allowing good quality shots.
Here's LeBlanc with 10 to shoot. LeBlanc fires, save, Poulin, almost a rebound, nearly trickles in. Resiterence was closest to it.
What a reaction by Poulin. Turn behind himself and get his stick on the rebound. If he didn't get a stick on that rebound, it was going in.
Around the pick, it's Zach Miller. Lyle Thompson is held up. No whistle, great check, Adam Bomberry. Isn't it great to have him back in the lineup, New England? Black Wolves possession.
Perfect example of using your body to defend one of the best players in the league, Thompson.
Crawford waiting patiently. Comes off the pick. Fires, save, Poulin. And Georgia gets a timeout off before any transition develops. Ed Colmo calling timeout. New England also has a timeout remaining as well.
Nice save here by Poulin. It's been outstanding today. He was screened too. Great position, stepping out on Crawford's shot.
New England, Jack, has won 11 more faceoffs today, but in the loose ball battle, as we've discussed all afternoon, it's plus 17 Georgia. So these fans are holding their breaths every time there's a loose ball in overtime. Again, it's sudden death. Next goal wins. So it is super uncertain. At one point, you turn your head and the ball's on the other end of the floor. So it's Georgia ball. What do you think the message was from Coach Colmo to his players?
Be a little more active off ball. Be more aggressive, more physical. New England being a lot more physical on the defensive end of the floor. We saw it on Bomberry playing defense against Thompson.
Here's Jackson. Three goals in the game for Jackson. Up top, shot, Zed Williams missed wide. The rebound, score! Georgia wins! The Swarm win it in overtime, ending a three-game losing streak. What a terrific finish. It was Miles Thompson who cashed in. This was off the rebound.
Got a great bounce off the shot. Heady play by Miles Thompson to get the ball off the boards. Nice release. I don't think Jameson, he wasn't set. He was still coming up off the first shot. Probably didn't even see the shot. Great play by Miles Thompson.
Well, and Zed Williams had the initial shot. We had mentioned it at the end of the fourth quarter, too. Lyle Thompson took a shot, went right off the board, and it perfectly fell in the lap of Randy Stotts. So it created a great chance, and Georgia comes through. Swarm trailed 10-7. Just minutes, or rather 1 minute into the fourth quarter, come back, tie the game, and get the win. Hard-fought game here at Mohegan Sun.
And the Swarm did a great job. Everybody was so active on the floor, whether it was on defense, offense, creating those turnovers, getting the loose balls after shots, whether they were on goal, goalie made the save.
So let's send it down to the third member of our team, Robin Brown. She is with the hero who had the game-winning goal, Miles Thompson.
Miles, that goal ends a three-game losing streak. Take me back to it right there. Where did you see the opening just now?
You know, just to mention, it feels good to get a win, you know, coming off a losing streak. But what I seen there is the same goal that I seen earlier. The ball come off the backboard, and I scooped it up, and I seen Dougie wasn't, he didn't know where it was. So, you know, that was my chance.
We thought this was going to be an offensive game, but it really was the defense that propelled you guys forward. What did you see about your defensive unit tonight?
You know, they obviously got a good defense. They got a good goalie, Dougie, in a net. But, you know, Mike Pullen played well, and our defense played as a unit. And, you know, it shows this is a defensive game.
Congratulations, Miles.
Thank you.
Brendan?
Thank you very much, Robin. And Miles Thompson, great moment on the floor. Rich Lisk is being honored. Once again, our final score, Georgia wins 11-10 in overtime. Be sure to join us on Saturday, February 1st at 7 o'clock when the Black Wolves are back at home hosting the Vancouver Warriors live on BR Live. Visit NLL.com for an all-access pass to the National Lacrosse League and get the latest news, highlights, stories, and more. For Jack, Robin, and Brendan, have a great rest of
Yes.